Hey tubers, you're looking at some Prestone antifreeze, 4 gallons of it. It's that time of year when the weather starts getting cold and you've got to do your checking. I checked my radiators last winter, if any of you watched that video, and you saw that I had, I don't remember, either 3 or 4 of my balls were floating. And so I was okay. I'm not gonna check this year yet. I'm gonna go ahead and drain all the water and antifreeze out of both tractors, refill it with brand new fresh stuff, and then I'll check and see where we're at after that. I know that the Prestone in the Farmall is coming up on being 3 years old, so I'm going to go ahead and change it. Alright, this is going to be multi-segmented, so I'll be back after a while. Thanks for watching this little piece. Okay tubers, what you're looking at there is my petcock to drain the water out. For you people in Rio Linda, petcock means drain. Anyway, you see it's got some of that white stuff in there that some kind of bug always gets inside your holes on your boat or whatever stationary item you have, and they seal it up and leave their eggs in there. I don't know what it is. See if I can get this to drain out. I want to take this opportunity to remind you, if you drain your antifreeze out, please dispose of it properly, especially if you have pets. Antifreeze tastes really good to pets, and they will drink it and it will kill them. And it's not a quick death, it is a slow, horrible death. So if you've got pets, make sure that you dispose of your fluid properly, because it will kill them. I'll be back in a minute. Hey tubers, I'm back just for a second. All the water and antifreeze is out of that petcock there, but the engine, I don't know if you can see it too good, the engine leans backwards. So there's another petcock toward the rear. I'm gonna have to drain that to get the rest of the water out. All right, be back later. Hey tubers, I wanted to show you inside my bucket. That antifreeze and water, well, you can't really tell too much on video, but I can tell you it's not very dirty at all. It's really pretty clean. See, oh look at that, you can see my reflection in it. Okay, yeah, you can see all the branches of the trees up in there. It's really clean stuff, but anyhow, it's better to be safe than sorry, so I'm changing it. Be back after a while. Hey tubers, I checked my book. The Oliver holds 4.5 gallons of water, coolant, whatever. So I did good by buying 4 gallons of antifreeze for the 2 tractors. So I'm gonna put 2 gallons in here, and then I'll put 2 gallons in the Farmall, and then top them off with water. And if that measurement holds true, then I'll have 2 gallons of antifreeze and 2.5 gallons of water. And for here in Texas, that should be plenty. You know, some of you people that live up north, you might have to run a 60-40 mixture in your systems. But here where I live, that's just not necessary. So I'll put 2 gallons of Prestone in, and then I'll put 2.5 of water. All right, thanks for watching.